Now let's make our journal entries with QuickBooks Online. Remember, all we have to do is enter the transaction in the journal entry window, and the accumulated totals will immediately change in the trial balance. And these are the same transactions that we have been doing for the entire course. So, January 1, 2025, the owner invested 50,000 cash into the business bank account. Now, the debits and credits in QuickBooks Online are the same as they were with QuickBooks Desktop. Here's the trial balance in QuickBooks Online, and if you want to record a journal entry, you click the plus sign, and in the right column after clicking the plus sign, the third choice down, click Journal Entry. Physically recording this is the same as what we did in QuickBooks Desktop. You have to change the date to the date that you want. We're imagining it's January 1 of 2025. Now, you have to decide what account debit and what account credit. We learn debits and credits, and we know that cash in Chase Bank will be debit if the owner invests $50,000. Push the tab key and keep pushing the tab key until it goes across. And now, the credit account will be owner's capital, because the owner invested the $50,000. And in the bottom right, at the moment you click Save and New, when you go back to the trial balance, just close the journal entry window and you can see cash is debit and owner's capital is credit. Let's try the next one. January 5th, pay $20,000 for more equipment. Well, what would be the result? Cash will go down by $20,000 and become $30,000, and equipment will show up for the first time as $20,000. So, we know we have to click the plus sign to make a journal entry, and we know the date is January 5th, and we know it will be machinery and equipment debit for $20,000, and you know, keep pushing the tab key and it'll be cash and bank credit for that same $20,000. And when we click Save and New, we can see that the result in the trial balance is exactly as what we expected. Now we'll do transactions that we need to make a journal entry for, because there would be no other way. What about January 10? The owner took home equipment worth $5,000 to not be used for business. Well, we already learned that would be equipment credit and owner's withdrawals debit. But what will be the result? Equipment will be credit and decrease by $5,000. So what do you think it will become? Machinery and equipment will become $15,000 and withdrawals will show up for the first time on the debit side as $5,000. Again, we click the plus sign, go down to journal entry, and we put the date January 10, and we know that this will be withdrawals, owner's withdrawals, debit $5,000, and it will be equipment, the asset, credit, and we already learned why. Now when we click Save, we can close the window for journal entry and we can see the numbers and the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Machinery and equipment is down to $15,000 and owner's withdrawals is a $5,000 debit. You don't need to make a journal entry if you establish a bank loan, but you could. Let's imagine on January 15th, we borrowed $35,000 more from the bank. Well, what will cash become? If cash right now is $30,000 and we borrow $35,000 more cash from the bank, then logically, cash will be $65,000 if we do this transaction correctly, and bank loan will show up for the first time. Click the plus sign, go down to journal entry. The date is January 15th. The account will be cash in bank, and we know that has to be debit because it's increasing. And when an asset increases, it's debit. So the balancing credit should go to bank loan, which is a long-term liability. And now when we click Save and New, we can close the window and see that cash in Chase Bank went up to exactly the number we expected, and bank loan shows up on the trial balance for the first time as $35,000. Now here's a transaction that you would definitely need to make a journal entry. What if the owner invested a personal vehicle worth $25,000 from his home and family and brought it to the business to be used for the business? What would capital become? Well, we know capital now is $50,000. So what happens if the owner invests $25,000 more of asset? That's right. Capital will become $75,000 and vehicle will show up for the first time as a $25,000 asset. We click the plus sign, journal entry, change it to January 20, and of course, vehicle or vehicles, how much will it be? $25,000. And that means that owner's capital increases to $25,000. And the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Now let's practice the opposite of one that we've done before. If we pay $3,000 to decrease the bank loan, what will happen to the bank loan? Well, right now it's $35,000. So if we record this properly, it will become $32,000. What will cash become? Well, cash is $65,000, and it should decrease by $3,000 because we're paying $3,000 in cash. So cash should become $62,000 if we do this correctly. So we click the plus sign, the journal entry, January 25th, cash will be credit for the three, for the how much? For the $3,000. And therefore the debit of the $3,000 will be the bank loan because we're decreasing the bank loan. When we click Save and New, you can see that the trial balance here in QuickBooks Online has exactly the numbers we expected. Cash, $62,000, and bank loan, $32,000. Now here's the last type of journal entry that you'll ever have to remember. If you assume a loan for an asset, like assuming a mortgage for a house, that would be the same thing as borrowing money specifically to buy that asset. So if on January 27th we borrowed $17,000 more from the bank to buy more equipment, that means we're assuming a liability for the asset equipment. We have more equipment, but we also have more bank loan. So how much will the bank loan become? Well, if it's only $32,000 now and we're borrowing $17,000 more, it should become $49,000. And how much should equipment become? Well, if machinery and equipment are $15,000 now, and we're buying more, By 17,000, that means equipment should become 32,000 and bank loan should become 49,000 if we record this transaction correctly. January 27th, equipment will be debit for the 17,000, and the $17,000 credit obviously will be the bank loan. And after we click Save and Close, the results in the trial balance are exactly what we expect. That's how we know we did the journal entries correctly. So you can use these videos as a model anytime you have a transaction that requires a journal entry.